We're less than 5 days away from Super Bowl Sunday, and more than likely, cooking and grilling will be part of your celebration at home. That's why today joining us is Albert Rodriguez with Longhorn Steakhouse, who's going to give us some great tips. And I hope you write these down, because I mean, take a look. This looks delicious, and you can recreate this at home, right?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, the Super Bowl is about, you know, football, great food, great, you know, great friends and great company. So we'll get to the grilling right now at Longhorn Steakhouse. A lot of people feel that maybe, you know, we feel that a lot of people think you can't grill a great steak indoor.
It's true.
So we want to get rid of that myth. We want to tell you that you can grill a great steak indoor. So here we brought a couple of steaks. So we've got a New York strip, which is lean and flavorable, super hearty. My personal favorite, the ribeye steak, right? Mm-hmm. So a lot of marbling, not a great flavor that goes through it. And of course, we have a fillet here, right? So extremely lean and the most tender cut of meat that you can find. So for today, we'll grab this ribeye right here. And of course, you always want to choose fresh, never frozen meat. Right?
Oh, so absolutely.
Starts with a great piece of meat. And then you want to season it generously. So grab a lot of seasoning. We're using actually one of our signature blends here from Longhorn Steakhouse. And you can recreate this with some salt, onion powder, kosher salt, pepper, onion powder, garlic powder. You want to get your grill nice and hot, right? Or your pan, whichever you're mm-hmm. using. 400, 425 degrees, and just let that steak
sizzle right on.
Right, so.
Now I understand 3 to 4 minutes per side, and you should probably flip it.
Yeah, you want to flip that steak, let it sit for 3 or 4 minutes, and then flip it, depending on what you're wanting, degree of doneness. Every 3 to 4 minutes and every 2 flips will give you, you know, kind of
the desired meat. There we go. Now, in this type of advice, Albert, you're telling us all meats can endure or go through the same process. You don't have to change how many minutes you flip each.
No, regardless of the type of steak you're cooking, it's going to be 3 or 4 minutes every flip. So once you flip the steak once, you'll be at rare. You flip it twice, you know, now you're going to be medium rare and keep going. So that's kind of the degree range that you want to go there. So
very good. Also, we talk about no frozen meats. I mean, that's a big deal. But what about me? I'm always confused as to what's the best texture, what's the best meat. Would you say that's depending on style and liking, or is there a particular meat you would suggest to our viewers today?
That is completely up to preference. You know, so there's not as, this is the best meat you can get. No, not necessarily. It's up to preference. You know, like I said, for me, it's the ribeye. You know, for a lot of people, it's the fillet. And some people who kind of like the best of both worlds, you know, would choose something like the New York strip. So it is really a preference thing. There's no bad choice in meat. But again, fresh is best.
Fresh is best, and we have those tips for you right now. Always choose fresh. You just heard the man. That's the best. Seasoning always helps. I always say I don't want my meat to taste like meat, and people think I'm so silly, but certainly the seasoning is great. Now, if you'd like to get some grill marks, what should people use?
Absolutely. So if you are grilling indoors, they do sell you know, these cast iron grates that you can use or you can grill on to give you some marks. If you're grilling outdoors, of course, no problem there, right? Your outdoor grill is going to give you those beautiful diamond marks that everybody is accustomed to.
Very good. And also, we want to encourage you again to flip it consistently every 3 to 4 minutes, so keep a close eye on that. And if you are grilling outdoors, what type of temperature should they keep?
Yes, if you are going to grill outdoors, you want to increase that temperature to 500 to 550. 50 degrees, okay? And you can also always keep one side of your grill maybe a little bit lower, maybe 150 degrees, so that once your meat is getting to the point where it's done, you can move it to just that warm zone and hold it there.
Awesome, very good. Before we go, Albert, tell us what you're doing for Super Bowl.
Yeah, so me, along like many others, will be off enjoying the game with friends and family, you know, and enjoying some great food with great friends, right? And for those of you who maybe don't want to do cooking at home, feel free to come on by Longhorn Steakhouse. We'll take care of the grilling and the cooking for you and bring your great friends.
Thank you for joining us today. Hey, we'll be right back with more. Stay with us.